This update is mostly about the general look of the game. You'll notice that I'm no longer using the low poly models. The gun model is now much more detailed, so is the environment. These are just broad strokes, meaning I haven't implemented detailed animations. For example, when you're reloading or running, the game works fine, but I haven't optimized this at all. The colliders are not yet fine-tuned, so you see the other character just floating there. I'm going to use my other computer. You can see the other character moves fine, but the colliders are not matching the models. But again, in this video, I'm only concerned about the general look of the game. I'm using the built-in render pipeline at the moment. I baked the lighting. I also have the light probes and reflection probes, as well as some post-processing. I'm going to have all the links below of all the assets that I'm using. But even if you like these assets, please be careful before you purchase any of them, because you're not going to get what you'd like right out of the box. In most cases, you have to add your own custom layers on top of them. Obviously, first, you're going to have to write your own code. And in this case, I also changed a lot of settings regarding materials, textures, shaders, particle effects, post-processing effects, lighting, shadows. There's so many settings that I changed with these assets that you might recognize the models, but most likely you're not going to get the same look even if you purchase them. So always be careful before you make any purchase. Contact the authors if you have to. Look into the details. Make sure that you're buying exactly what you want. And every game is different, so you have to look at it case by case. I'm generally happy with the current colors and mood, but the only reason why I'm using the old built-in render pipeline is because the very first asset, the low polygon models, that was done in the built-in render pipeline, and I just stuck with it. But if you've seen some of my previous videos, you can see that HDRP offers so much more details regarding lighting and shadows. And lighting and shadows make a big difference in how your game looks. I'm not thinking about real-time ray tracing at the moment, simply because I don't have the latest GPUs. But I'm also willing to experiment in the future if I have to. So let me know what you think about the current graphics. You can reach me on my Discord server. Again, all the links are in the descriptions. Leave comments if you'd like, or if you have any questions, you're welcome to ask. I do want to try HDRP, but changing render pipelines is a lot of work. So I might just work on the gameplay updates first. I don't know, but we'll see. Thanks for watching. I'll see you next time.